एक डाल दो पंछीर बैठा कौन गुरु कौन चेला ओ, 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 ओ गुरु की करनी गुरु भरेगा गुरु की करनी गुरु भरेगा चेला की करनी चेला रे साधु भाई उड़ जा हंस अकेला ओ, 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 ओ एक डाल दो पंछीर बैठा कौन गुरु कौन चेला
नमस्ते डियोंस टुडे आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट आश्रम्स एंड स्पिरिचुअल बिजनेसेस टुडे मेनी मोर गुरुज द सो कॉल्ड गुरुज सेल्फ प्रोक्लेम्ड यू नो गुरुज दे हैव सेट अप सो मेनी आश्रम्स and they run literally the spiritual businesses and they have a modern name for it they call it wellness business because today modern man is so busy working and these people are so busy setting up their spiritual businesses to suck money from them by giving them some some little peace it's not actually the permanent peace the so-called illusionary peace like a drug some pill they will give and so these people are happy and these gurus are happy sucking money from them and these people are also happy dancing around them so I want to talk about this great leela or the great thing that's happening in the world today. Prior to getting into this, I want to talk about one exercise that I want to give you. Let's see what happens. Let's imagine you have your father, and let's imagine you have three brothers, brother A, brother B, and you are one brother. You are one of them. And let's imagine that your father has given you, say, some 10 grands of your currency. To each one, he's given 10G to this man, 10G to this man, and 10G to you. You are C. So father said, okay, boys, I'm giving you 10 grand to each one. Whatever you want to do, you do. I will not ask you what you want to do. So, what he will do is, the eldest brother, he will say, I want to enjoy with his money. So he will go spend in some discotheques or from dancing around with friends and, probably he will spend on drinking liquor, booze and all. He will spend. Totally. It's all bad activity. Let's call it bad activity. And what he has done was, he says, father, I want to help some poor people. Maybe I want to donate this money to the people who are not having proper food and also he will go donate this money to some orphanages. A donation basically. So he earns, this is good activity. This is good activity and let's call it good karma. This is bad karma. This good karma earns, this bad karma earns bad karma. Means bad reaction. Basically you accumulate more karma by doing bad activity. And this man, he earns good karma by maybe he's donated today 10 grand. Maybe when he needs some money, when he is in bad times, probably the nature will give him more money than he needs. So that is good karma which will be accumulated in his bank account. This is bad karma that will be accumulated in his bank account. Now let's go to the C guy, what he has done, that's you. He is a very wise man. He knows how the law of karma he knows. So what he does is, father, I do not want to do anything with my will or desire. This man has his own will and desire. His own will and desire of doing bad karma. This man also has his own will and desire to do good karma. This man, when it comes to this man, now that's you, you are actually dropping off the will and desire. You are dropping it. You say, Father, I am not interested to have my own will and desire. You tell me what you want me to do with this 10 grand. If you tell me, I will do. Otherwise, you take back your money. I am not interested in doing anything. I just sit idle. I am disinterested in doing anything. So, Father will say, how can you do like that? No, you do whatever. He says, no, I don't want your money. Take it back. If you tell me, I will do it. Then the father will say, let's imagine the father is nature. Okay? Nature says that, look, today many more people are suffering from coronavirus on the earth. Why don't you stitch some masks and all people, especially people, doctors, nurses and all are not having proper masks and all. So you go buy some material of making masks and all. You get them stitched or you get them made and then supply them to all the people. This is the need of the hour for nature. I'm not talking about you and me and all. As per the nature, this is the need at this moment. Need of the hour. This is the priority basis. On priority basis, this is the need of the hour. And then he has asked you. The nature has asked you. So you go and then, get those things done and then supply it to all the people. Now this man, he neither earns bad karma, nor he earns good karma. This is the perfect way of doing karma. This is called the independent karma. Independent way of doing karma. This is not dependent. This is, you are not dependent, you are dropping your will and desire and then depending on the will of the nature. So, who is the doer here? You are not the doer. The doer is the nature. It may be a big task today. No shops are available for you to buy these materials. No people are available to help you and all this. Today, all markets are closed. But then, because this is the work that is given by nature, nature will make certain ways for you. Nature will naturally arrange some people for you to get the material, some people who can work on this, some people who know how to prepare all these things. Maybe nature will also make the ways in such a way that the material and all these people are available for no price. Maybe they will work only free of cost. So nature will arrange all the things. Nature is the doer here. You are not the doer. You are just being a vehicle here. Whereas here, you are the doer. Because you are holding your own will and desire. In bad karma and good karma also. Whereas here, he is not the doer. So let's imagine, he has earned the bad karma. That's okay. Maybe in the process of going to, say, discotheque, this A man has involved in an accident. Meaning, he is hit some man. So he gains bad karma again. So in the process of doing bad karma, he has done another bad karma and he has accumulated the bigger amount of bad karma. Now let's come to this man. Now he is gone to do a good job. He is gone to do a good karma. But even this man, let's imagine, in the process of going to some orphanages and all, on the way he has done the accident. He has hit some man. So that will also become a bad karma for him. In the process of doing good job also, he is met with the accident. He has done the accident. He has hit some man. So he earns the bad karma again here. But let's come to this man now. Now this man, in the process of going to all these people, are probably going to stores and all, he has also done an accident. He has hit some man. Now the karma will come to this man or not? Karma will not come to this man because he is not the doer. Nature is the doer. Nature will absorb the karma into its own vast space. This man can never accumulate any bad karma because he is independent. He is not the doer here. He is just following the instructions given by the nature and it's not his job. He is disinterested in doing any job. So, nature is the doer. And he is sacrificing, he is disinterested in doing. It is it is not his own job for the sake of the nature, for the love of the nature, to help others, you know, for the universal sake, for the love of the nature, he is sacrificing his peace, he is disturbed himself, he is come forward to do all these jobs, and in that process, he is hit a man, and that karma will definitely go to the nature. This is what Lord Krishna says to Arjuna. You know, how to leave the arrows. Arrows means karma. How to leave the arrows. You know, perfectly, Arjuna knows how to leave the arrows. That is the reason why he always holds the arrow. He is a good warrior. So, perfectly he can leave the arrow. And the arrow is independent karma arrow. And this arrow is actually left by Krishna. You only see Arjuna here. But Arjuna is not there. It is Krishna who leaves the arrow. And it will go hit some people. And all the people will die. And the karma will go to only Krishna. It will not go to Arjuna. And Arjuna is not the killer. That's what even in Bhagavad Gita he says. You are not the doer. I will be the doer. So all the karma goes to Krishna. And because Krishna is actually Purusha. Who is working with nature. You know, Krishna also is working here. Krishna is working for nature. So Krishna also doesn't get this karma. It will get merged in the nature. He has done this entire thing, whatever the actions that Krishna has done, for the love of the nature, he is come down for the love of the nature, to balance the nature, to balance the nature and to kill adharma in nature and to bring back dharma into the nature. He is done this operation. So, Arjuna will never get the karma. So, in the example I have told you, you are required to operate as per the instructions of nature or God or Guru to do the perfect karma. God or Guru or nature. So, do you have access now? Can you talk to God or Guru or nature and get your instructions properly so that you can do an independent karma? Like see, no, you don't have access to Guru or God nor nature. So you are totally dependent on your own mind. Your mind is obviously you have your karma. You are born in the world. You are working for some company. You have family. You cannot stop working or going to the company. Oh, karma to this whole universe. You not only owe the karma to your family, but also to the whole universe. So, you cannot basically stop working. And because of karma, you have a lot of traits in you. Your mind is not clean. Your intellect is not clean. And how can you have access to God or Guru or nature to get the proper instructions? So, you are totally dependent on your own mind. See, so just like A and B brothers here, you will either, sometimes you will end up doing a bad job. Sometimes like B, you will do a good job. Either bad or good. Bad things will help you to gain bad karma. Good deeds will get you good karma. But you can never know the independent karma. The independent karma to do, you need to become Arjuna. You know, everybody cannot be Arjuna. Did Krishna work with Bhima and all those other brothers? He did not work with all those brothers. Arjuna is the best amongst all the five. So he works only with Arjuna. And Arjuna's mind, intellect, everything is clean. And he can gain the access to God or Guru or nature. Krishna is Guru for Arjuna. Krishna is nature for Arjuna. Krishna is God for Arjuna. So it's him who directed and he could properly leave the arrows. So, my question to you is, now you do not have access to Guru or God or nature, so you can never be able to leave the perfect arrows with independent karma. Okay? This is the way of actually doing the karma. Now, my topic comes down to the gurus and ashrams. Okay? This example, you keep it behind. The example of A, B and C brothers and father. Let's keep it aside. Now let's come to our great gurus who are running these businesses. So what these gurus do, you know, these gurus, you know, maybe they must have gone through their own gurus or somewhere, you know, they will learn something, they will meditate, and they will go through the self-realization process in a very, very big way, and by that time they will become 45 years old or 50 years old, they become old. Okay. Now, in the process of self-realization, they get to know some techniques of meditation, knowledge they gain. See, knowledge is different, okay? And then technique that takes you to deeper levels of meditation into samadhi is different. Knowledge is different. But above all these things, do you have a thing called a great ingredient which is must actually, detachment? Do you have this element in you? My question to the guru, whoever has set up these ashrams, does he have the detachment? He doesn't. Now, because he knows this technology or technique, because he has the knowledge, now everybody wants to go out and then teach people. Several people come to me and say that, you know, they have gone through some spiritual process and all. They want to come to me. They want to become my disciples. I will ask them, why do you want to become, why do you want to follow my path? They will say, you know, I want to help the world. I want to teach the world. I want to teach the world. The world is suffering. I want to teach the world about spirituality. First of all, I'll ask him, fool, first of all, you become clean first. Teaching others is different. That is secondary. First of all, are you 100% clean? No, some people are so bad in such a way that after coming to me in about 10 days, whatever I, you know, whatever the communication they have, whatever they learn from me, they will start teaching other people. They will open their own schools and teach. And they will start collecting money. You understand? Now, this guru, what I am talking about, is he doesn't have the detachment. Now he has a thing called great desire, you know, desire of teaching others, okay, becoming famous. That is one thing, becoming famous and getting money. And another thing is authority. So many people should be there around to do all the bhajan, you know. Oh, great guru, great guru, great guru, okay. He has knowledge. Knowledge is a different thing. Knowledge he will give, but he can never have the access to the greatest knowledge of nature. Source from this, you know. This is where everybody lacks actually. When Rama was there, great gurus, his own gurus and sages and all surrounded around him. He, in one incident, he will act in a different way. Action one he does. In the same incident again, if the same incident comes, he will act as two. He does a different action. So, all the, including his gurus will ask, how do you know this? But we know inside that this is as per the dharma of nature you are doing. But how do you know? He doesn't talk anything. He will only smile. You know, what he says, to me, only dharma is important. Only dharma is important. What is dharma? Dharma is nothing but sanatan dharma it is called. Know what is Sanatana Dharma means? Sanatana Dharma means the most ancient one, the very first one, the very first one. The Dharma is called the laws of nature. That is the manual, you know. That is not a book actually. Manual doesn't mean it's book. It can only be known by becoming Purusha. Because Rama was Purusha. That knowledge I am talking about, knowledge of actually knowing the perfect knowledge. You know, having the perfect knowledge can only come to you when you become a Purusha. When you become Purusha. Because the other gurus, even his own gurus, did not become Purushas, so they were lacking that knowledge. But they initially taught him ABCDs and whatever the initial levels of it, because he was having the body, they taught him. But because he is actually come down as a Purusha, he knows, he has access to the nature, and he not only has the access to the nature, but he becomes the hero, and he has a heroine, that is nothing but nature. They both are companions, wife and husbands. They work like partners to set right the things in the world. And this Purusha, what does he do? You know, he doesn't set up any ashrams. He will only walk the path by showing what is Dharma. You know, first 10 years, Rama went and learned the first 10 to 15 years. Till he became 15, 17, 16 years old, he learned all the things from his guru, Vasishtha. And then he came home. And then another Vishwamitra came, another guru. And this guru actually taught him all the wars, you know, how to lead the arrows, how to use the sword and all these things, and how to follow Dharma, and what is meditation, and all these things this guru taught. And by the, when Vishwamitra came, this guy, Rama, became a perfect warrior with Dharma. So Vishwamitra says, "You are a young man, what are you doing at home, sitting idle? You come, we have a huge forest. In the forest, you know, all the rishis, munis and all people are practicing spirituality. And these rakshas, negative energies are not allowing them to do, practice all those things. So you come and kill all those people. I want you to fight. I need a warrior. You are the best warrior." So he goes for about a few, couple of years, 1 year, in a span of 1 year, he will kill all those rakshas here. Now this Vishwamitra again takes him forward, and they walk through the forest and all, to meet Sita's domain, Sita's kingdom. So these people, when they walk, they meet Ahalya and many more other rakshas and all, they kill. Now Ahalya was actually waiting for Rama, and Rama did not plan actually. Rama did not know about the future. He actually met her just as per the situation. As per the situation, he gets guided and then goes. Who guides him? The nature which actually guides him. The situations. Situations, whom to meet, people are actually manifested by nature. And he is the Purusha. So Purusha works with situations and Prakriti so that he can meet actually the perfect people as per the directions of the nature, and he will work with them, and then he will do the actions. So now let's come back to the point of Guru. Now, is this Guru a Purusha? Is this Guru a Purusha? He is not a Purusha. First of all, these thieves, who are running the businesses, they are not Purushas. So they know some technique, they have some knowledge, and then they want to teach people to basically become famous, to make money and to get applause, satisfaction of ego. So for this sake, what they will do is, they do not get the directions, because they are not Purushas, they don't get the directions from Prakriti. Means, the need of nature at this moment is addressing the problem of coronavirus. But this stupid guru, what does he do? He runs after the non-objectives of nature, such as, teaching about this technique to people and tom-tomming his knowledge. So he goes after this. It is not the preference of nature. Nature doesn't want this actually. It is your itch, our desire, our traits, our karma. All these actually are driving you, they are forcing you to do this job. Now what do you do? Now you have a product. He has a technique, he has some knowledge, so he will productize it. He will very, very nicely, in a modern way, Americans are very good at packaging things, right? So he will also package his product. He is the product of spirituality. He will nicely package it. He will nicely name it. Some technology he calls it. Or something else. Some science. Some engineering. They call it. And they nicely design everything. you know. And he, what he wants to do, he, just like any other company, just like any other incorporation, he has plans to set up so many branches across the globe, you know. So now, what does he do is, he will either raise the funds, just like any other company, or in a slow way, he will start taking money, because he has a product, he will accumulate money, he will say, give me some money. He will say, give me some money, and you know, all these fools, you know, will come and then sit. They pay money to him. He will talk about all this product, and he will, with that technique, you know, they will slip into some mild, you know, confusion mode, and which they feel like meditation or samadhi they feel. These people also are great at ego, right? They have great egos. And he will pamper, this guru actually will pamper this, the ego of all these people, you know, you guys are actually great, you are meditating, that, this and that. So these people will become heroes now. They will think the great meditation is happening with them. the mild, you know, sleepy mode, they will think like it's like samadhi. And now these people, now what so he earns some money. So he will multiply that money, or he will get the money, he will get the funds into this organization. He will call it actually spiritual organization. And then he will take some people. He calls them actually what? Volunteers. He has a great name called volunteers. So my question to them is, volunteer does not eat food. He needs food 3 times a day. He needs clothing. So minimum you need to spend about 10 to 15,000 Indian rupees per person. And this man would definitely have somewhere around some minimum 20 to 30 people as such, whom he calls volunteers. So I think actually these volunteers don't eat food, they only eat air. And they don't need any clothing and all, no money is required for them. So just out of the air they will start working for him. And all the world is fool to listen to it. And in fact, the world is fool. And this man says, now how can I make, if you don't pay me the money, how will I take care of these people, he will ask. Huh? He has volunteers, whom he has to bear, say 20-30 people, minimum somewhere around 5 lakhs of rupees, that is about 12,000 US dollars per month. For all these people he needs. And where does he get the money from? From you people. And he will also have a good profit, because he is not just these 20-30 people. And there is a cost of this person also, guru. And this guru is not ordinary guru. And this man would have great cars, great flying machines and all those. So his cost itself would be another minimum $10,000 for him. So $20,000 he needs, $22,000 per month. So where does he raise the money from? He raises by collecting the money from you people. Now my question is, which way is he different from regular incorporation? Let's say there is an incorporation called Microsoft. Microsoft is a pure business, and they openly say, yes, we need profits, and we have employees, we need to pay money to them. So my product cost is this much. Okay, my product cost is X is my cost, he says, and he openly gets the money, incorporation. This man is much perfect in terms of Dharma of Nature. As per the Dharma of Nature, all the companies are perfectly in line with the Dharma of Nature. But whereas this man, the so-called spiritualist, he is not actually as per the Dharma of Nature. He is naming, he is calling himself, he is in disguise mode. He is actually calling himself a spiritual organization, and he is operating the business as an incorporation. And he has so many other benefits, such as not paying taxes to the government. And he can avoid so many things, so many benefits he gets from the government. So many benefits from the government services he gets. Electricity free. Huh? And water free, he doesn't have to pay for it. Land free, he doesn't have to pay anything for it. And you know, not just one, he has so many, he set up so many businesses around the world. And, you know, they will claim that, you know, they have reached some billions of people, millions of people, as if he has totally re-engineered or probably totally restructured the nature. He talks about any guru. Huh? So actually, are they working as per the nature? They are working out of their own itch, basically, which you people need to understand. You fools need to understand that the guru is actually functioning as per the dharma of nature. Or is he functioning out of his itch? It is his self agenda. It is not nature's agenda. It is his personal agenda. Like that bee brother. He wants to go donate money to orphanages. So like this bee brother, this is his self agenda. At least this bee brother did not expect anything. He just wanted to donate and he donated. But this man is much more dark. He is meaning he is totally with the knowledge he gained in spirituality, he is applying that knowledge to cover the eyes of people. He is blocking the truth, the sight of truth from the eyes of people by using this knowledge. So he has a disguise called organization, spiritual organization. They organize so many retreats, they call them. Today, a fashionable word called retreats. And they have a product, so many products. They not only address these individual people, they go to incorporations. They go to so many businesses. And they make them fools. And they make them sit down in this technique which will slip them into sleep. The great, what is it, samadhi. This is the greatest samadhi of slipping into sleep. So they have a technique that pushes you into the sleep and then you say that it's samadhi. And they, some little piece they get and then they spend a lot of money, all the incorporations. And the spiritual organizations have become such great in a level, they are actually building platforms, business platforms to organize, to invite so many companies there. You know, it's become a business platform. Like, you know, this is a spiritual organization. And they call so many companies, C1, C2, C3, C4, all top-notch CEOs come in and sit. And to this event, they sell tickets to normal B-grade or C-grade, C-level companies. They call their CEOs and marketing managers and all to this event. They say that, you know, what do they teach here? Little about spirituality, that sleeping technique that puts you into sleep. And then they say that this is some economy, you all need to churn around. So many that knowledge to fool others has come, right? He knows the knowledge to fool others, to wrap a mask, to blind the eyes. So this event, you know, when probably once a year, twice a year they organize, and what kind of business happens, you know? Some millions, it's a trade business, some millions of transactions, business transactions and deals will happen there. And this organization, the spiritual organization, maybe they sell the tickets, or probably they will also want the cut out of those deals done there. This is the actual drama that is happening there. Huh? And they will set up, so they will come up with so many products. The ancient India has given so many, those Ayurvedic products. To do meditation, they sell yoga mat. They sell yoga mat for $500. That mat they actually make from the woods of, the forest, which is hardly available for 100 rupees in India. And they sell that mat for $500. And such products, great products they have. They not only have yogic products, but they also talk about now health, They give lot of lectures on health and all. So basically, like an incorporation, they are setting up so many products, business solutions to get, to earn money from the market. So there is no difference between the spiritual organizations or the gurus and the companies, the way they are operating. There is no difference. Purely, but this is easier way of getting money, in fact, for the spiritual organization. And the spiritual organizations, they advertise on Facebook, they advertise on Google. Google AdWords, they spend, they have budgets, you know. And they spend on Facebook, they spend on newspapers, they spend on hoardings in cities and all, they organize events. They put a hoarding, you know, a hoarding should definitely cost somewhere around 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs minimum for 2 days or 3 days, that's nothing but some $20,000. So, if they are spending $20,000 on the hoarding, imagine what kind of money they are collecting from the people who attend that event. So, is it not a business? Is it the dharma? Now, where the story started actually? Because this man had the itch or desire to present his technique, to present his knowledge to the people, he has created this whole drama. But actually the nature did not tell him, he is not first of all a Purusha. To listen to nature directions. Next level, at least he does not work like B brother here. Now, he works like B brother with some expectation again. Some business model he has. So what happens here? What happens is, you know what is the problem that he is causing? Or that guru and organizations or such organizations are causing? Imagine the nature has a plan to advance the world or cosmos in the next 10 years. Let's say the nature wants to advance about 10 kilometers or 10 miles. Now, nature has its own objectives. Huh? So, it's moving at a speed, at some degree of transformation of the whole cosmos it is moving. Nature, transformation, some percentage of transformation. Nature is working. Now, this man, is he falling in the path of nature? No. Let's say the wind is blowing in this direction. Now these gurus, the gurus of all these organizations, are they falling in the direction of nature? No, they are going in a different direction. They are taking the contents of nature, people, all the souls, you know, they are taking them in a different direction. Like, you know, imagine this is the path actually. Some A to B is the path of nature. Now these gurus, you know, they will take the they have reached about some 1 billion people. So they will go in a different direction. X direction. Some other guru will take in a different direction. Now what nature has to do? In order to go here, nature has to again bring back all these souls into this path. And then go here. Meaning, the evolution of the nature is falling behind. So these people, in a way, are not helping the nature anyway, but they are hindering the advancement of nature. So, are they actually working for the nature? They are working against the nature. They are not working for the nature, right? But they have so many jargons, the knowledge that they got out of the spirituality, they can blind any man. They have such convincing, because they not only carry the knowledge, but they also carry certain energies. Because they have done the tapasya, right? So they have the energies. So all the people, today everybody has zero energies. Obviously all will be tied to this knowledge and the energy, and they are basically doing their businesses.